Do you remember this little guy? This is the brain of your Raise keyboard. And today we're going to meet what we call the soul of the Raise. Hi Digmates, I'm Dominique, head of communications at Digma. And today we're going to find out what the firmware is and how you can customize the one on your Digma Raise keyboard. Let's start with the basics. What is firmware? Well, we can describe it as the most essential piece of software in any hardware. It's the code that enables the chip to behave in different ways. Almost any electronic product has some sort of firmware. Otherwise, those devices, no matter how basic they are, wouldn't respond to any sort of command. For instance, without firmware, your TV remote won't change channels, or your washing machine won't know how long it would take to wash your clothes. Your computer won't start when you press the on button because the BIOS, basic input-output system, is nothing but firmware, the one that performs the booting process and allows operating systems to run on the computer. So yeah, the firmware is essential for any electronic device to work. That's why most manufacturers store it in the EEPROM unit, away from the customers, so they can't, by accident, change anything on the firmware, like turning a mobile phone or a printer into a brick. But we're not like most manufacturers. Both our software and firmware are open source. Why? Because since we started our project, we've gotten such good feedback from our community. So we thought, why don't we make it open source so that our community, our customers, can contribute what they want and also make improvements on the product. And they can program their own plugins. And we thought that this would create a very positive impact. Our base code is online. You can download the latest firmware code on our GitHub, where you can find the information and the steps to modify your firmware, build new versions, and flash them back to your keyboard. This is a hot topic in our community, and it's even hotter when we launch a new update because, you know, this is when problems show up. But don't worry about that. Our Digmates help us find the issues, and our tech department solves them quickly. Well, they better do. Otherwise...
No, please! Please!
Last but not least, you have to remember this. The firmware is not something you play with. As we mentioned, most manufacturers hide it, and for good reason. Toying with it may have catastrophic results, like making your device useless. But that's not the case with the Raise. We have developed a bootloader mode on the Raise, which will be there to save you and restore your Raise to default mode, no matter how naughty you get with your Raise. However, when you do go to bootloader mode and restore the settings of your Raise to default, you might lose your settings and the layers that you've already configured. So it's always advisable that you save your layers or your customization before tinkering with the firmware. You can always ask for guidance in our subreddit or by emailing us or messaging us in our social media channels. Our Digmates are eager to share their knowledge and our team is more than happy to help. So don't be afraid to share your doubts if you have any questions, because that's the first step of learning. And don't worry if you feel uncomfortable changing your settings in the firmware. BaseCore has a lot of customization tools in a safer environment, because you can always go back to your original layer and remap the ones that you're not working on. If you're interested in more information about this topic, like the video and let us know in the comment section below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel
or face the consequences.